Now, let's discuss the basic parts, or sometimes we call it as essential parts of a business letter. These essential parts or basic parts are very important when we are writing or when we are preparing business letter. In the absence of any one of these basic parts, we can call it as a complete business letter. And what are those? Okay. First, we have letterhead, then inside address, salutation, the most important one, the body or message, complimentary clause, and signature. Again, these are the six most important, basic, essential parts of business letter. Again, in the absence of any one of these, we cannot consider our letter as a complete business letter. Okay, let's discuss them one by one. So the first one is the letterhead. Always your business letter must have a letterhead. So if you are connected in a particular company, so normally a company, especially if it's a big company, they have this so-called letterhead. What is in the letterhead? Okay. It is the part of the letter which is printed at the top of the stationery or paper, consisting of the sender's name and address, sometimes with telephone number and trademark of the company. In the letterhead, below of it is the date line. In the date line, you will include here the date, the month, and the year the letter is written or typed. Look at this example, okay? This is an example of the letterhead. So normally, the letterhead is placed at the upper center of the paper or stationery. But it depends upon the company. Sometimes there are some companies that they have different style of their letterhead. So normally it's printed. So you don't need to write this letterhead. So in the letterhead, the name of the company, the address, and sometimes the telephone number. So this is an example of the letterhead. So below it is the date, because it's the date line. So in the date line, you will include here the date, the month, and the year the letter is written or typed. So that is the first essential or basic part of a business letter. Okay. So next is the inside address. In the inside address, it includes the name and address to whom the letter will be sent. So in short, the addressee. So the one who will receive our letter. Okay. So in this example, the receiver of our letter is Mr. Sydney Player. So in the inside address, you will include here the name of the receiver, the address, or the complete address. That's what it's called as inside address. Now, in case you don't know the exact name of your receiver, so you will, maybe you are going to what? You are going to think, who will be the receiver of my letter? Especially, for example, you are going to apply for a job and you don't know who will be the receiver of your letter. So you will what? You will assume that the receiver of your letter is the president, the one who is holding the higher position in the company, or the manager of the HR, so human resource department. So in that case, if you don't know the exact name, you will say, for example, the president, then the name of the company, then the address. Okay, or the HR manager, then the name of the company, then the address. That is, if you don't know the exact name of the receiver of your letter. But if you have already known the name of the receiver of your letter, write the full name. Sometimes we include the position. For example, Mr. C.D. Player, president, Coca-Cola company, you will include the name of the company, then the complete address that is allowed. Okay. So this is an example of very common inside address. Now, the third one is salutation. Salutation is the greeting or the opening line of the letter, which is usually punctuated by a colon. Okay, so, example, dear Mr. Player. But sometimes, class, you will notice that some letters, they do not include this greeting, the word dear. Sometimes they will say only Mr. Player. That is also allowed. It is more formal. Because when you say dear, it is considered personal. Maybe you have knowledge or you have already known this person, that's why you said dear. But that's allowed also. Now, colon is normally used as a punctuation in salutation. But in some other letters, in informal letter or in friendly letter, we do use what? Or we substitute comma to a colon. But in a business letter, we normally use or punctuated salutation with colon. Okay. Number four, the most important part of the letter, the body or the message. So, this is the text of the letter or the message or messages that you as a writer wants to convey to your reader. This is usually typed in a single space. So, this is an example of the body or message. It is typed in a single space and normally in between each paragraph of the body or the text, it is in a double space. For example, first paragraph, it is written in a single space. Then, before the second paragraph, double space. Then, second paragraph, single space. Then, to the third one, another double space. Then, the third paragraph. So, normally, that is how you are going to write your text or the body or the message itself. Okay. Number five, basic part is the so-called complementary clause. What is complementary clause? This is the writer's closing remarks or a parting phrase, which is always punctuated by a comma. So normally we say, sincerely yours, comma, cordially yours, yours sincerely, respectfully yours. There are so many ways on how we are going to state our parting phrase. Now, take note of this, that when you are going to write your complementary clause, always the second word is in small or starts with small letter. The first word is in capital letter. For example, if you are going to interchange it and you will say, yours sincerely, that's also allowed. So, why in yours it will become the first word in your complementary clause? It will be written in a capital letter. And as in the word sincerely, since it will become the second word, it will be written in small letter. Always, the first letter of the first word in your complementary clause is in capital letter, and the second word is written in a small letter. And always is punctuated by a comma. If the salutation in a business letter is always punctuated by a colon, in complementary clause, we always punctuate it with a comma. And the last basic part or essential part is the so-called signature. So, signature, this is the name of the writer, which is usually followed by a business title. The handwritten signature is placed just above the typewritten signature. For example, the one who prepared this letter is John Ryan Reyes, and he's the manager of the particular company. Okay, this is what we call the typewritten signature. Then, the position of that person. Now, above his typewritten name is your handwritten signature. So, what's the purpose why we are putting or including our signature, affixing our signature? To show one, the authenticity of our letter, that we are the one who really writes this letter. Okay, so those are the six essential parts or basic parts of a business letter. Now, I will show you the complete or an example of a business letter having these six essential or basic parts. So if we are going to combine all the examples from the letterhead, dateline, then the inside address, salutation, then the body or message, plus the complementary clause and the signature, we will have an example of a business letter with complete basic parts or essential parts. And this is the example. Look, so this is our example of the letterhead. So it's given the name of the company, then the complete address together with the contact numbers, then the dateline, the inside address, the salutation, the body, or the text, the complementary clause, and the signature. So all the basic parts or essential parts are included. We have, again, the heading, the inside address, the salutation, the body or the text, the complementary clause, and the signature. So all the six essential parts are present. Again, in the absence of any one of these basic or the essential part of a business letter, we cannot consider it as a complete business letter, because the essential or the basic part or one particular basic part is missing. Okay, what have you noticed with the example? So always the spacing, proper spacing in between each essential part is double space. Then for the content or item in its essential part is single. Look, from the heading, single, then from the dateline to the inside address, double, then the items in the inside address is single spacing, then from the inside address to salutation, double, then from salutation to the first paragraph of our text or message is double. This salutation, this is our first paragraph, double. Then the item or sentences in the first paragraph, single. From first paragraph to the second paragraph, double. Then second paragraph, single space. Then from second paragraph to the third paragraph, double. Then from the third or last paragraph to the or to the, what do you call this, complementary clause, double this one. Then from complementary clause to typewritten signature or signature, normally double. But sometimes there are persons who have this very big signature. That's why it is allowed, or sometimes we do give enough space for those writers of a letter who have a big signature. So we give these spaces. So 2 to 4 spaces are allowed from complementary clause up to signature. But if the person has a very small signature, so 2 spaces or double space is enough. So again, those are the 6 basic or essential parts of a business letter.